Eita, hola, hola, Eita. Sure, guys, it's your boy Makapane. I'm back in the show, Bola show. Yes, please like, comment, and subscribe. Eh? And subscribe, guys. Okay, today we are going to speak about Mamelodi Sundowns Football Club. They've been a little bit busy in the transfer window this period of time. This season, I might say, for the 20, getting ready for the 2021 to 2022 season, and yeah, they look ready for the part. And yeah, I just want to go dive into it. The way I'm seeing Sundowns recently, they've been buying so many players and so many players for a certain position. So that's also trying confusing that. What are they trying to achieve? It's like having four players in the left back, which I'm going to touch a bit more on it as the video prolongs. And yeah, so I foresee people being unhappy, you know. So maybe we should go through their squad, or maybe we should go through the players that they've brought in. So let's only check the new signings. Which is Gran Kekane, which is 28 years old, and yeah, he'll be playing right back, and he knows how to play center back, which he looks promising and he looks good. And another player they have, it's Neo Maima. Neo Maima played for Bloemfontein Celtics, a really good lad. I like how he makes all the combination passes, but again, it's a very tough squad to break into the first 11. So it's gonna be a big one. But this one I can already see him play. Divine Lunga, very versatile. Wing back, right, left back, and yeah, he can advance in up high. Into more attacking positions. So yeah, I see Lunga being played regularly, and yeah. And as for Sfrenko, you know, Sfrenko is a center forward, which I saw he's from Serbia or Slovakia, I'm not sure, but correct me if I'm wrong on my comments there. So he's I guess we have Sundowns has Alfonso. So what's the difference between Sfrenko and Alfonso? So that's one thing that I'm not getting. Sorry, Alfonso. So that's one thing that I'm not getting. What is the difference? I mean, I've seen his YouTube videos. It's not like I was following him. As soon as I heard that Sundowns is signing him, I went and made my own research, and I saw like he's not wow, you know. He's only got like 10 caps on him, and I think he scored 12 last season, if I'm not mistaken. But he scored 9 last season. So I don't know what's the big fuss about him. And yeah, and then we get Sfiso Ngubeni, another one, left back. I don't know what they're trying to fix in the left back, because already they have Langerman, but I think Langerman is already aged, stage 5, and he wasn't even used last season, so I think he'll be hitting the road. And you've got, we've got also, who's this? The other left back, Lekki. Lekki was playing there last season, did a good job, and you also can bring Modiba on it, on the same left back, but Modiba he's more versatile. He can play left back, can play up front. We saw that last season, how they played him in different positions, but he can also slot in the left back position. So I don't know where Ngubani is going to play, because honestly, it's already a crowded position there. And then you bring Kutumela in it. That's another new signing. Scored 12 goals for Maritzburg last season. And, very exciting talent. Very hardworking boy. But, hey, then again, this is Sundowns. Is he going to break into the 11? Because he might see himself not playing for a certain period. So, with this Sundowns squad, they've got very strong players, very talented squad. But my concerns are,
is everyone going to be happy?
You know, that's another tough one. You know, it's a really, really tough one. But let's just go through the team. And I think they've got like over 40 players. Man, who buys 40 players? A squad of 40 players. Is everyone going to get a chance? Yes, we know that they are playing a whole lot of competitions.
But is everyone really going to get a chance to play? We don't know.
But then again, I can see unhappy faces because I know from experience because I'm coaching an SAB league team. So I know what happens with players if they're not getting game time. They become happy, mischievous, and they start influencing with bad behaviors in the group. Even if you can try and control that, it's very difficult because when you are a player, you want to see yourself playing. But then again, I think when you see the contract and when you see what they're offering, you already see, hey, this is a life-changing opportunity. But then again, we forget that it's only an opportunity for maybe 5 years or 3 years. And in that 5 years or 3 years, will you be playing? That's the question. Would you be playing? But then again, let's look at the goalkeepers department. You've got Oyango, who played the most minutes last season, who is in his prime, because we all know goalkeepers, as they age, it's where they are very, 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 very good. So with Oyango, you are also getting that they are maturing like wine. Is it like what? Yeah, like wine. Yeah, they mature like wine. Goalkeepers definitely don't mature like cheese. Eh? So we've got Oyango, we've got Gross, we've got Peterse, and we've got February, and we've got Muyeni. And Muyeni, we all know, he's the second goalkeeper. So we've got, this is going to be a tough one. You've got 5 good goalkeepers, and we all know 1 or 2 or 3 will play, but the ones going to be dominating is Oyango, we know. And then we saw Gross coming in last season, just a few minutes. Haven't seen Peterse, but I heard that he might be out. But no, I'm not too sure about that. But the rumor mills, you know, they've been confusing. So, yeah, you've got 6 good defenders and... Wow, 6 good goalkeepers. This is like, wow, man. Okay, and we go straight into the defenders, centre-backs. Libusa played a really good season last season. We've got Diruk, Nantimento, Oyango, Somahuro. These are good centre-backs that we've saw and showed. And they show their capabilities. So, this is going to be a tough one. To break into the starting lineup. But we already know who's going to be playing. So, Dirugu looks like the one guy who I am seeing playing consistently. And Libusa, he has shown his fighting spirit into the 11. So, yeah. That's about it. So in the left back positions, that's the position that I was talking about. Let me just show you the left backs. You've got Lekki, you've got Lunga, you've got Ngubani, you've got Langerman, and you've got Mudise. He's from just came back from his loan from Maritzburg. And still, he wasn't playing much in Maritzburg, and now he's back into the first team here, Sundowns. So what's going to happen with him? I mean, 3 good defend left backs, like top-class left backs in South Africa. Lekki, Lunga, who's playing for Zimbabwe, and he's in the national team as a starter. And you will be seeing him in the World Cup qualifiers. So This is a tough one, guys. This is a tough one with all these left backs. And the right backs, we've got Morena, who we've been seeing playing regularly. And we've got Kekane, who's a new signing from Super Sports. So we'll be seeing more of him. And we've got Mubeni, which we haven't seen a lot from him. He's been out loans, back in. And, yeah, Mudau. I think he's promising. He's promising. He showed his character last season when given a chance. But, of course, we all know Morena gives it all. And Morena is in it and in it to win it. And that's the character that Morena brings in the lineup. And the defensive midfielders, we've seen Andile Jali in it. We've seen Kotsia. We've seen Kekane. Kekane haven't been playing much of the time. He's not been playing, even though he's the captain. So yeah, and we saw recently, I think they renewed his contract to 2024, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. So we've also got Mkhize, which I don't think he was promoted, I think, 2 seasons from the academy. He hasn't even gotten his breakthrough into the first team. It's tight. It's really tight. And not that he's a bad player, but the standard is really tight. And you've got Maluleka in the central positions, more central midfielder. And you've got also Megaman, who was bought recently. And you've got Mudiba. But Muliva plays more on the left midfield. And you've got your attacking midfielders. You've got Vilagazi. We've got Maima, who's been recently bought. And you've got Pewa, who was loaned and he's back again. Is he going to make it? We don't know. We all know that Tembazwani can play in an attacking midfielder and he can play as a left winger or a right winger. So it's going to be a very tight one. And then we've got Makgalwa, who can play as a left wing and also center forward. But I've heard in the rumor maze that he's going to Swallows, but we don't know about that. We'll see when it happens. So we've also have Mkuma was promoted last season from the academy, and now he also got a few game time in it. So you can see the caliber of players that I'm calling. Someone is going to sit down. We can't play all 11, even if we can have so many games. I mean, next week, that's the when MTN 8 starts. And I don't think Sundowns will be going in not to win it. They'll be going with the strongest squad and looking to win everything. So it's going to be a tough one here. It's going to be a tough one. So we've got my boy did good. Very versatile. Can play defensive mid. Can play middle field. Can play as a 10. Can play as 11, can play as a number 2, as a right back. So he's very versatile. He can play as a right wing back. So this is going to be a very tough one. And he's one of the players who got a few minutes last season. He got a lot of minutes in his belt. So yeah, looking forward to see more of him this season. And yeah, from there where we Serino. Oh, Serino, with all the talks and rumors that he's thinking of leaving but if he's really staying there, we all know what he can bring on the table. Very creative and can play in between the spaces. And yeah, he's a typical number 10 that any team would be looking for. He can create chances, he can take chances. So what else are you looking for from a number 10? So we've also got Mkulisi, who can play winger, but we've seen him playing more central and he's been dominating. I guess he also got a whole lot of minutes last season. Eh? So that's one also we should be looking for. And we go straight into the second strikers, or the strikers, I might say, or the center forwards. So you've got Mutupa. Who can also create chances and score chances. We've got Domingo, who can also create chances and score chances. So we've also got, You know, the center forward, I don't know why they brought him in. It's just to crowd all these spaces. Sfrenko, who we've seen height, pace, he can also add a different dynamic into the team. But I don't know what Afonso can do. What's the difference that Sfrenko can do and what Afonso can't do? I just don't understand. And if you've got Kutumela, is he going to get game time or what? 28 years old and he still have time. You're getting a good contract. Maybe they are paying him very well. So now he's made it. But it's not all about that. It's about breaking into the team. And then you have Rasmus, who was also not getting a whole lot of minutes like he got in Cape Town City. And now he's been denied so many minutes. Is he going to really break into the team? And Kapinga, ever since he came from Black Leopards, he has shown good signs of a good attacking player. He can play attacking mid. I saw that he can play winger. I saw that he can also play center forward, which is a great player. Kapinga, would love to see him play more, but again, who is he competing with in the starting lineup? So it's a very tough lineup, to really think about it. So guys, let's also look who got more minutes last season. So we saw that I've also forgot who got more minutes. This is the last player that I'm gonna talk about, and this is one player that I want us to also focus on, Peter Shadulile. Oh, great player, man. That's a great player. He scored 15, he assisted 5 last season, which is a good player. It shows a good standard. And let's just move into which players are going to really bring excitement and bring goals and bring stability in this club. Which are the three players that I think that in Sundowns we should be looking for and we should be looking forward to see in this coming season? So firstly, of course, I've already mentioned Peter Shalulile. He scored 15. He created 5. I mean, he assisted 6, by the way. He assisted 6 goals and he also got 25 appearances. So he got a total of 2,161 minutes, which is a lot, and he's amongst the highest. And you've got Lebohang Mabuya, 27 appearances and 2,154 minutes last season. That shows that the versatility of this player. If there's somewhere missing, you just can just slot him in. Even if there isn't any position that's missing, you've always want the player of his caliber in. So, yeah. We're looking forward to see him play more and more and more and more. And I don't see anything different this season. He'll be playing, definitely playing, because he's got so much energy to burn. He can play 6, he can play 8, he can play 10, he can play 11. So he can also play 2. So why are you keeping him out? And even when he's been played any position, he gives us it all. So this is one player that we are definitely looking to see. And of course, how can we forget Themba Zwane? He's been a very good performer for Mamelodi Sundowns for quite some while. Huh? So he with 25 appearances in him and 10 goals and 1 assist last season with 1,993 minutes under his belt. So he looks really good, and I'm looking forward to seeing him. So yeah, that's about it. Let me just have my final touches about Sundowns. I don't think Sundowns will have it easy this season. They are really going to struggle in getting goals. Oh no, they won't struggle in getting goals. They won't struggle in creating chances. But the thing is, I think with all the so much talent in the team, they are really going to struggle to keep everyone happy. And that might be a case where you more management than just going out with the team and performing. You know, a smaller squad is best. Or maybe if Sundowns can loan most of the players and leave a core of teammates of a team that they are going to use. I mean, what are you doing with almost 40 players or above 40 players in a squad? So we all know it's going to be a tough one. Yes, we know there are many other tournaments, but we saw last season, not everyone got a chance and not everyone got the minutes that they wanted. So it's going to be a tough one. Yeah, but that's up for me today. So thank you for tuning in. And guys, please like, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe, guys. Please, I'll give you more on this show, Bola. And yeah, catch you on the flip side. Sure.